Hey guys, this is Marshall Kirby from Orchard Hill Farm Equipment, and today we're going to be going over two features that Kioti offers on their CK and DK as well as NX series compact tractors. These two features are known as a linked pedal kit as well as a cruise control kit. Cruise control is pretty, you know, self-explanatory. This is something that's only coming on a hydrostatic tractor and is something that is an add-on option for certain models and also will come standard on certain models. So the cruise control kit basically is going to be a button or a lever that as you press down on your hydrostatic pedal, pushing it to the floor at some point, you click on your cruise control and lock it. Very similar to a cruise control in a car. When you're at the speed you like or the rate of speed you like, you lock down that pedal with a button or a lever. So pretty simple. We're gonna show that in a minute here, how that's done. Next feature that is gonna be an optional piece to add on to certain models, but it might also come with certain models standard from the factory, is going to be something called a linked pedal kit. Linked pedal kit is a pretty common option sold here if the tractor doesn't come standard with it. Linked pedal kit basically is meaning that I call it a linked pedal kit or an auto throttle, basically the same thing. So on a hydrostatic transmission, normally your throttle has to be set with a hand lever on your dash to a certain RPM and stays there. With a linked pedal kit, you're able to actually control that with your foot pedals now. So you have a forward and reverse foot pedal, obviously for your hydrostatic, and the harder you press forward or the harder you press reverse, the higher the RPMs go. And they're synchronized with your pedals. So as you take your foot off the pedal and the pedals come back to you, the tractor slows down, but it also slows the engine RPMs down with it as well. We're going to do a demonstration on that in a minute so you can see just how that's done as well. Couple common things though, link pedal, it's a great feature. However, if it's used wrongly, it can definitely hurt the performance of the tractor. So just know how to use the link pedal. Have your dealer give an overview on how it's actually used. It's not ideal to run a link pedal on the tractor and keep the tractor at a minimum idle, because what you're doing is going from 0 to 100 as soon as you mash the pedal to the floor. So it's good if you're running the link pedal to have that auto throttle feature set up, but it's good to run the tractor already at a third crack throttle or a little over that, maybe even half. That way you're not 0 to 100, you're maybe say 50% throttle to 100% throttle. Just helps the tractor keep up with its speed and be more responsive with that link pedal kit. So anyways, that's a little of an overview of these few kits. We're going to do a little demonstration now, so stick around, check out the video. So this is the link pedal kit right here. This is a lever you're going to activate by pushing down or up. Right now up is going to be on. If you do have the tractor on, link pedal light is going to come on the dash here. So we'll start up the tractor. We're going to turn it off right now just to show you what it does on the dash so you can see. And we'll fire up the tractor real quick. So link pedal is currently off. Tractor's just at an idle. We turn it on. Notice it illuminates over here. That's link pedal on currently. And now we're gonna leave the throttle, like I mentioned. We're gonna crack the throttle to about a third, give it a little RPM so we're not bogging the tractor down and going from 0 to 100. So we're at a nice like 1800 RPMs right now. And I am going to show you how this works right now. Close the door. So we're gonna press harder. We're gonna press the pedal down lightly. In medium range, we'll start out in. And you'll notice harder, throttles it up, and it goes down with everything. We'll do it in reverse. Doesn't have as much activation in reverse, but it does work. So again, we'll try one more time. As we press harder on that forward pedal, you're gonna notice our RPMs rise. So again, one more time. Here's the throttle stationed at about 1800, 1900 RPMs. As we press forward, we're gonna watch the RPMs rise. And then then come back to us.
Next is the cruise control button, located all the way to the right of your tilt steering wheel on a DK10SE. We're going to lock it on right now. We're going very slowly, about 1800 RPMs. You'll feel the magnet grab the foot pedal. You can let your foot off and notice we're still moving here. Cruise control set. If you want to turn it off, just release it, disengages. That tractor operates under normal standards here. Pretty simple, easy to get used to. We'll show a quick view of that again.
Thanks for watching the video, guys. Leave a comment in the comments section below if you want to see more Kioti videos, and let us know what you want to see, as well as give us a like on the video, and of course, subscribe to our YouTube channel, like us on Facebook, check out our website, www.orchardhillsales.com, and give us a call if you got any questions, parts, service needs, or anything else. 413-253-5456. Stick around.